Hi, welcome. We hope you haven't really been waiting too long, but we've been having a couple of technical issues here at the studio. I think that this time everything is ready to go. So welcome to our little presentation on the AdSense Management API. I'm Sergio. I work in the London office on the AdSense APIs.
Okay, and I'm Jose, colleague of Sergio's. And we're going to talk about the agenda first. There you go. Right, so first, Sergio is going to define some concepts, important concepts to understand the rest of the session. Then he will be talking about OAuth 2 and the wonders of authentication. And
always an exciting topic.
Yeah, and authorization. Then I'll be talking about channels. I'll expand the reporting section that we did last event, and I'll talk about the new V1.2 features.
Right.
Then, if we have questions on the moderator page that you can find on the
Google Developer site, yes.
Yeah. Then we'll talk about them.
Yep. Okay. Yeah. So if you have any questions during the presentation, just don't hesitate. Go to the event page, leave your question there, and then at the end of the session, we'll be taking a look at it. All right. So as you mentioned, Jose, I have a couple of definitions that I'd like to get started with. And if you're an AdSense user, you probably know most of these concepts already. But with the AdSense Management API, you can develop applications not only for yourself, but for other people as well. So the typical example would be someone who develops an Android or an iPhone application to access AdSense data. And they can use that application themselves for their own AdSense account, but they can also develop this and just make it available in the app stores and have people buy the application or give it away for free, and sign up into their AdSense accounts and just be able to take a look at the information there. We're also going to be discussing how all of this happens securely. So, keeping on this slide. So in terms of basic concepts, there are four main concepts that I want to introduce here. The first one is ad units. Ad units are essentially predefined slots where your ads will appear. You log into the AdSense website, and you can configure everything there from colors, sizes, all sorts of options that define exactly how you want the look and feel of the ads to be on your website. Then there's ad clients, which are a bit of a tricky concept to explain, but they're essentially a relationship between an AdSense product and your account. So as an AdSense user, you might actually have access to several products, for example, AdSense for content and AdSense for search. And for each of these products, you'll actually have something called an ad client in your AdSense account. Then there's channels, which Jose will get into a lot more detail during our presentation later on. But they're essentially ways of organizing the information so that it later shows up correctly in your reports, and you can track things according to different ways of organizing your data. And finally, the reports, which are where you can generate where you can get the data for your impressions, for your accounts performance, your earnings, all of that stuff, which are extremely detailed and very configurable as well in the Management API. So what does the Management API run on? As all of our newer APIs, it's what we call a RESTful JSON API. It uses REST as the, I guess, methodology, the mechanics of the API are REST. You make RESTful requests, which in the case of the AdSense Management API are read-only requests, so you use GET mostly. And there's a couple of, in the case of the AdSense Management API, there's one custom verb, which is generate, which is used for reports, but most of them are standard HTTP verbs that are used. And in the format in which the data is transmitted to the API and from the API is JSON, which is an industry standard format as well. And it has the advantage of actually working with programming language primitives, associative arrays, and arrays in general, text, strings, all sorts of native data that you can directly load into your application and have it. It's not a hard thing to parse like XML is. It's a lot easier to use. And finally, the authentication and authorization mechanism that we use across all of our APIs, OAuth2, which I'm going to be talking into a little bit more detail later on. So in terms of ad units, I've got a little slide here to show you how they look. Again, this is completely configurable. You can change the colors, you can change the sizes, and this will be filled in automatically with ads relevant to the content on your page. In terms of how you should be developing, we recommend that you use the client libraries. We've gone to a considerable amount of effort in developing them for multiple programming languages to make your whole life a little bit easier. It's a little bit like when you're connecting your speakers. You don't want to use the raw cable. You want to put a banana plug on the end of it to make your life a little bit easier.
Nice.
And in terms of support, we've got things like Go, PHP, Java, Ruby, JavaScript, all sorts of different programming languages. But again, always remember, this is a RESTful JSON API. You don't have to use the client libraries. But you know, if you do, they'll make your life a whole lot easier with things like OAuth and being able to just code things as is expected in the specific programming language that you're using, rather than just having to compose your own raw HTML requests and all that.
Yes, especially for OAuth.
HTTP, rather. Yes, especially for OAuth. All right, so how does this OAuth thing work? Now, if you're a Google developer, you've probably used OAuth before. I mean, it's what we use across all of our APIs, I think. There's still a couple of legacy APIs that use other authentication mechanisms, but it's the one we're pushing forward now. It's an industry standard, and it's got a couple of interesting features which allow for developers and users to be different people and still keep everything secure. So as a sort of a high-level overview, it starts by the developer making a request against the API. The user gets a prompt, which you can show, you can see here on the bottom part of the screen. And this prompt not only tells them what application is trying to access their data, it also tells them exactly what data is they're trying to access. And once the user approves it, the developer gets granted access to the data. And this access comes in the form of tokens. There are two types of tokens. There's the access token, which is the important one that is actually used in the requests. But it's a short-lived token for security reasons. It only lasts, if I'm not mistaken, 3,600 seconds, something along those lines. And then there's the refresh token, which is actually a long-lived token. It does not expire unless the user specifically revokes access to your application. And you can use this at any time to generate new access tokens as needed. So I'm just going to give you a little overview of how to get started on a project. I'm not going to go into too much detail on how to perform the whole OAuth setup, because that would take a live event of its own. But I'm just going to give you a little introduction here on how to get started. So first, you want to go to your API's console. If you're a Google developer, you've probably already used it. If you're a new developer, this is the place where you can set up, give us your details, your credentials, so that we can set up OAuth securely. You'll see a page like this asking you to create your first project. And when you do, you'll want to go into the Services tab and make sure you enable the AdSense Management API, which is what you'll be using with, as well as any other APIs that you'll be using on the same project. After that, you'll need to go into the Access tab and create a new OAuth2 client ID. And there's a bunch of different options that you can set up here. But the important thing, again, we're not going to go into too much detail on those, because that would take a whole lot of time that we don't really have. But the important thing to note is that at the end, you'll get something like this, which gives you your client ID and your client secret, which is what you'll need to input into your client library's configuration files, or if you're not using a client library, into your own OAuth methods, to get the tokens back from us.
Okay.
Right, so over to you and custom channels and URL channels.
Thank you. So channels are the tools that let you track data in order to organize your reports. So the first type is custom channels. You can define custom channels on the AdSense web interface, and you can use it to track different sizes, ad units, colors, sections of your page, and you can then filter the reports to get the data you may need. But if you're actually tracking sections of your site, you might want to use URL channels. These are also configured at the AdSense web interface level. So all it takes is a domain or subdomain, I think, and a path. So everything that comes below that path is tracked by this URL channel. But you have to configure them beforehand. Okay, so set reporting. This can be as complex as you want, but let's start by using some examples, some very simple examples. The first one that you can see there, it's just a simple report that, given a date range and month as dimension and earnings as metric, it just gives us a table of months and earnings. The second example has two metrics. So we are combining earnings and page views. But as you can see on the rows property, it's just a new column. The problem comes when you combine dimensions. As you can see here, we're combining country code with month. So for each country on the database, or I guess for each country that accessed the...
For each country for which you have some impressions, yes?
Yeah. You get a month. So it's basically the number of months times the number of countries. Mm. So this can get really... This can generate a really big report. So you might want to limit your number of dimensions to two or three, depending on the dimension used.
There's usually not much of a use case for any more than that.
Mm-hmm. So you can think of the dimensions as the data represented on the x-axis. You can see there the current list of dimensions. We have some for dates, some for ad units, channels. This is an important one, and some other advanced dimensions that you may or may not need. Same thing with metrics. It's like the y-axis of the function that we are representing, and some important metrics are clicks, earnings, or page views. Okay, so you can combine as you wish the metrics and dimensions, but you can also sort them by...
Well, not entirely as you wish. We do have a few limitations, but...
Yeah, there are some incompatibilities, but... Mm-hmm.
You'll get a warning if that's the case.
Yeah, sure. So yeah, I was saying you can sort them by dimension or metric. And also, you can filter them. This is very, very powerful, actually. You can filter by country, by channel, by size, whatever you want. And also, you can combine filters, so you can use ands and ors.
Yes, we have a we have a whole documentation page on that. But essentially, you can put a filter on anything that is a dimension.
Yep. So, if you want to try the reporting engine that we have, go to the API Explorer. Don't try to code everything in directly. This is a very handy tool that we use all the time, actually. You can use it to define the dates, the metrics, dimensions, sorts, basically all the fields that you'll need. Okay. So the new V1.2 features. There are a couple of new features. The first one is ad styles. It's just a read and list, well, a get and list resource. So it's only to it's just to list on and get your ad stats and your colors, your fonts, your corners, all that you have saved previously on the AdSense web interface. And also, the same thing with saved reports. Instead of going to, instead of configuring at code level your reports, you can create them on the AdSense web interface, save them there, and you will generate them using an ID. I see there's some kind of a problem. It's okay. Okay. So here you have the Save Reports Manager on the AdSense web interface. So if you first list the saved reports, you get the ID from there. And you only have to use this ID to generate the reports. And you get exactly the same report and as in the common generate method.
This is useful if users already have their reports set up and they don't want to have to reconfigure everything, but just access the reports they already have. You, as an application developer, can develop an application that lists all of their existing saved reports so they can just hit the button and get the same data through your application that they would via the web interface.
Mm-hmm. So that's it.
So shall we take a look at our list of questions then?
Yeah. Let's see. We don't have questions. We have an entry and
right.
It seems like spam. So
well, that's what you get when you have open forms on the internet.
Yeah.
All right.
So I think that's all, right? Well, yeah, don't forget to check out our blog, which is googleadsdeveloper.blogspot.com, our G+ page, and also the main support tool that we use is the forum.
So yes. So if you have any questions, if you have any technical questions on how to use the API, if you have any issues with OAuth, if you have any questions at all, just come to us on the forum, and we'll be taking a look at your question and answering it, and hopefully getting you started developing your application as quickly as possible.
Okay. Thank you very much.
All right.